I met three little home girls, two from L.A. and one from the LBC. And now they work for me. I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and these are Doggy's Angels.
What's up, cuz? It's your boy. It's 2000. We about to get it cracking on the West Coast.
I don't stop on your mind, ass real.
What's up? You know what I'm saying? I said I was gonna do more West Coast throwbacks because the West Coast hip hop is one of the. It's like for real. It's as important as the East Coast. Let's just face it. West Coast will do some shit. You know what I'm saying? From Chronic, Dolly Style, Warren G's Regulator, Exhibit, The Alcoholics, King T, Brother Lynch Hung, E40, Bonzarelli, The Clip. Rapping Potage, Too Short. The list goes on. I can name a bang up. But I think it's time we got on some West Coast females. You dig? And I opened my mail today and look what I found.
Ah! My Doggy's Angel C came in today, nigga. What?
I know you're probably like, who the fuck is Doggy's Angel? It's Doggy's. You already. You hear Doggy, and on West Coast, there's only really three types of dogs you can really think of when it comes to the West Coast. So, main one is Snoop Dogg, then there's the Dog Pound, and then there's Too Short. Short dogs in the house. But Snoop Dogg is responsible for this. And I know y'all probably thinking, oh, God, no, no, no. Why? Why? No, but actually, this is some... This is one of those West Coast gems right here. This shit right here. If you haven't heard this album before, and you're a fan of the East Siders, this is like that third East Sider album that... It's like, let's say, if Snoop Dogg, Trey D, and Goldie Lowe was dating these chicks, and they wanted, they're like, all right, baby, we're going to give y'all a chance to make an album. And gave them a chance to make an album, this is what you would get. This album is basically probably one of the best female rap groups I've ever heard in my life. I mean, you know, you probably think, ah, nigga, that's Salt and Pepper, and you can't really think of no one else. That's real talk. Okay. Basically, this group is comprised of three women. Big Chan, a.k.a. L.A. Chan, Coniyac, and Kola. Alright, these chicks, they were basically formed by, you know, Snoop Dogg. Released one album, this one right here. This one. They released the album called Pleezbaleevit. Pleezbaleevit. And basically, they ran into one major problem. Well, there's two problems, but one major problem. They said Doggy's Angels, and this is around the time Charlie's Angels came out. And we know how white folks is when it comes to their properties. The white folks like, oh hell no, we can't have these niggas doing that. So of course they filed some injunctions and just, so they changed the name to the Angels. But when it comes to money, I think this is what ruins good music and good hip hop. Money. Because everyone wants to get paid. You don't, there's no such thing as someone doing it for the love. Everybody wants to get paid. They may want to get paid for what they do, but they want to get paid. You know what I'm saying? So, you got the label owners. I mean, I ain't talking about Snoop Dogg. Snoop Dogg own Doggy Style Records. But you got TBT Records. They want it. They're going to get paid. Not they want to get paid. They're going to get paid. They get the check first. Then Doggy Style Records get the money. That's Snoop Dogg, basically Snoop Dogg. His cousins and them. Then the ladies get paid. Okay. Now, we know females are high maintenance. They probably got kids. They probably got a life and whatever. So, they probably saw about 30 grand each. And that was enough. They didn't really produce any major hits. Their first single was called Baby, You're Ready. That was actually a real good song. That kind of introduced a female, Latoya. And that actually, the single ascended to number one on a Hot R&B and hip hop song. So didn't do too bad. And the album itself was the Billboard Top Independent Album number 8, you know, in the Heatseekers chart, 35, number 35 on the top R&B hip hop chart, chart number 7 on the Top Independent Album. 1,000. So that's not bad for some females, you know what I'm saying? I ain't saying that, you know, the females, blah, 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 blah. But that's not bad for a rap group, period, especially their first time around. But like I said, they had some hits, you know, they had Pleezbaleevit. That was with Lazy Bone for Bone Thugs and Harmony. That was, and the album itself had some slap. And you know, for all you white folks that don't know what slap means, I mean, not speak. I believe it was just basically a West Coast gumbo of choice. You put it in and you forget that you're listening to a female rap group. You got Nick Dogg, Snoop Dogg, Goldie Lowe, Sugar Free, Lazy Bone, Mac Minister doing, he got a little intro on here. Cocaine's on here. Superfly, you know. I mean, some low name dudes like King Lou and Rough Dogg, I don't know who that is. But the East Side has made his appearances on here. And then Snoop Dogg was basically kind of overkill. Man and everything, but Snoop, you had something good with these chicks. I would have gave him a second run. You gave the East Side a second run, I would have gave them a second run. Because these chicks actually did it. Big Chan, L.A. Chan, she's the one who kind of stood out the most lyrically. You know, she also stood out the largest because she's the tallest. You know, and I think that's sexy. Yeah, LA Jam. I like a chick that can whoop my ass. That's know? Just me, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Like, give me that dick. Yeah. It's
time to represent.
But,
Doghouse.
They just banned it in 2002. So, they did the movie, the Snoop Dogg, Eastside's movie, which made no sense with the Eastside group. That's what's me. But, gonna find out that, 2005 10 actually sued the label for $100 million in royalties for a performance in the band, and they still out in 2006. So I'm pretty sure she's probably like, oh, don't eat that nail. So, but like I said, this is one of those groups that I really wish they would have risked budget in their career, you know.
She wasn't really telling me no, but she really wasn't leaving me no. You know what? She wasn't really leaving me no, even though she said she told him so. You know what?
She wasn't really telling me no, even though she wasn't leaving me no. You know, when it seems like whenever I have a good album, people talk shit about me having it. About that good bullshit, but good shit is always the shit that's part of the
And don't be afraid to make it good. You never know when they gonna be on my ass.
sexy ass. Just stay ready to get it. Get digging. When the bitch niggas get bridges, I holla at a real bitch to come kick it. She wasn't really feeling you, no. But she really wasn't leaving you, no. You know what? She wasn't really leaving you, no. Even though she said she told you so. She wasn't really feeling you, no. Even though she wasn't leaving you, no. You know what? You know what? She wasn't really leaving you, no. Even though she said she told you so.
Yo,
holla at you, boy. You got a throwback with this is a song. If it came out between, if it came out between 85, I'd say 2005, and it can't have a hit. It can't have, you know, no kind of affiliations as far as hit, super duper hit. And they are not around anymore. That's a throwback, and I'll do it. So definitely hit me with that. And I will definitely do it if it's working. I have to know about the group too, but I know a lot about me, so it's rare that I wouldn't know. So anyway, set them throwbacks. Doggy's Angels definitely set them throwback. It's 2000. Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Tumblr, Google Plus. Y'all already know what it is. Subscribe. Hit me up. Love. Time for y'all to vacate the premises. Y'all chickens on shattered dreams and broken promises. Not only do we mind shit, the whole click bang. On wax, we top dogs, and we came to run things. You ever wonder what happened to BET Uncut? Until next time.